I don't know, you know, after, I don't know if they just, you know, after we asked them nicely to leave, I don't know. I was, you know, I can't keep track of everyone, you know.
Okay, you know, next time, I mean, it is your private property without a doubt. You have the right to, you know, bear arms and defend yourself here and whatnot, but definitely next time, try to just give us a call and we'll get them.
Yeah, yeah, you know what, next time, and now that I know you guys are around, I feel much safer, and if I do have a problem with them, I will give you a call.
It'd be awesome, sir. And what was your name?
My name is Timmy McApone, actually. Oh, this is my my associate here, Mr. Tony.
Hi there, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, Mr. McApone. And Tony, pleasure meeting you. You guys have a great day, okay?
Thank you as well, my friend.
Thank you, officer. Right now.
You know, have a great day. You know, stay safe out there. I don't want to, you know, you look like a good guy.
Look after yourself,
thank
sir.
You, thank you.
Have a lovely day.
Bye now.
There's a bunch of gun pig scum. Yeah, fuck off.
Those news guys ratted on us. They said that we beat on their truck or something.
Wait, which fucking news guys?
I don't know. There's two different news reporters that showed up and they reported to the cops and said that there was a problem here.
Let them know they don't report on this property.
I'll
see which one sounded like him.
Me and Killen gonna deal with these reporters, okay? Hello there. This is Anthony D'Angelo. I'm manager of Killian Enterprises, and I'm looking to, you know, promote my singer here. He's a very talented singer. Looking to maybe get some coverage of him. Wondering if I can set up some kind of meeting with you guys to show off his skills.
I just got a call about a shooting down at McDonald's. I can come after.
Oh yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah, we can meet at McDonald's and maybe we can go from there to wherever you want to go and film. That'd be great.
Sure. Yeah.
Okay, we'll see you there soon.
Hey, you feel like going through the drive-thru?
Okay, but I go fuck yourself. Sir, what's your name again?
My name's Edward Kenway.
Edward Kenway, this is your truck, yeah?
Yeah, with ANN News.
Yeah, this is my client, Killian. If you're getting a truck, you can follow us to a more private area. Maybe you can film, do a bit of a song and see what you think.
Sure.
Okay.
Nice.
Just follow the car. Come on, Killian.
What song should I sing?
You know, I like that. I like. Mm-hmm. Fly Me to the Moon. Honestly.
You like that one? All right.
I do.
Yeah, I'll do that one. I'll do that one.
Get Killian. Just go in the middle of these rocks here. And
the gray hair, maybe?
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, there's fine. Okay, yep. It's the cameraman over here. Get Killian. I want to hear, you know, Fly Me to the Moon.
All right, let me get this started up.
All right.
Woo!
It's really fun.
Here we go.
We do. You're going to love him.
Fly me to the moon, let me sing among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Yeah! Fill my heart with song, let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love get away. Oh.
Fucking beautiful, fucking beautiful, keep it going.
Hey! Fill my heart with song, let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please. Bang.
Okay, Mr. Cameraman. Don't know if you can fucking hear me or not. Okay? You seem to be moving. So I'm supposing you're still alive. It's good. It's good. It's good to have a tough head. Let me just tell you something. The Macapone residence is off limits to people of your kind. Don't know if it's you or your fucking buddies. So I want you to spread the word. Once you've fully healed and recovered, you tell all your camera fellas. You stay away from T's house. Well, next time, I'll put another fucking 5 in your head. Understand? That's good. Have a nice day, Mr. Kenway. Violence to me, it's like second nature. When I was younger, I remember getting the shakes. I couldn't even hurt a fly. But I've been doing this for so long now. It's just business. It's just my way of life. It's how I put food on the table. I'm not proud of it. But I ain't ashamed either. My name's Anthony D'Angelo. And I just got out of prison. I served 10 years. But now I'm back on the streets. My best friend, Timmy Macapone. He went from just being a wise guy when I went in. Now I'm coming out, and he's the boss of the whole damn show. When I heard that news, I was goddamn proud. What do you hear? What do you say? T, how you going?
Hey, yeah, I'm not bad, man. You're looking pretty good.
With my best friend as the boss of this family, we had the world by the balls. I mean, we could do anything, get away with anything. Back in the day, we had to get permission from the old fucks upstairs to get anything done. But now, if we want to go steal a fucking car, fuck it, let's do it. We wanted to do a multi-million dollar drug deal? I mean, why not? What's the goddamn difference? We own the town. Who's gonna stop us? The cops? We had them in our pockets. If any stupid fuck got in our way, we just dug a hole. Simple as that.
You owe the family about 11 grand. Is that right?
I don't think so, no.
You don't think so?
I paid my loan back.
You paid your loan back. Hear this guy, he's saying that he's paid his loan back. You got an hour to send the money back. If you don't send the money back, I'm going to come to you. And if I have to come to you, I'm not going to just tear your fucking legs off. I'm going to stick them up your ass. You understand? Deep down, I kind of wish they couldn't pay the loan back.
Come on, man.
Consider the debt settled, bitch. But as the saying goes, all good things come to an end. your truck?
Yeah.
No, no.
What are you carrying in there?
Trash.
Oh, yeah? Make much money?
Decent, like $200 with bonuses, but you have to travel like 4K, so it's not really worth it.
I see. So,
yeah.
Do you stop at any of the major cities? Do you stop off at some of the major cities?
Yeah, there's actually a job task like 1 kilometer that way, but I'm not going to it. I am done for the day.
If I was to give you something to deliver, you'd use your truck to do that? This is Tony.
Hey, how you doing? What's going on, man? Hey, sorry, I had an issue here.
What's going on?
Yeah, well, you know, I had to get rid of someone out of the fucking family, and his pockets got a little heavier while ours got a little lighter, so he decided that he, you know, now that he's out of the family and he paid off his debts and everything, he's out now at war with the family. Where you at, Silverlake?
Silverlake, yeah.
Alright, where you at? I'm driving around.
I'm at the car dealership. Who's this guy we're talking about here?
Yeah, Mr. Black.
Mr. Black? You want me to fucking handle it?
I think I've got another option on this one, you know. I think I got another option.
So, Tony, how you been, man? You alright? You good?
Not too bad. I was just talking to some truck driver. He delivers garbage around all this, you know, he collects from all the cities, and I thought maybe I could organize something where he delivers, you know, other packages, you know, for us throughout the, you know, the lands and the cities, go around, maybe just drop off packages here and there. You know, it's a bit inconspicuous, you know, garbage truck, the cops aren't gonna check it. That'd be a good idea.
That's a good idea, yeah. Yeah, you gotta conceal it, man. That's why I always disguise what we're doing here. It's another business, so that, you know.
Exactly.
People look into it.
What are you talking about? We're Macroponus Cavations. What are you talking about?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly. Well, yeah. I mean, now that, you know, if we're tapped, yeah, that's what we're saying. But yeah, my man, we gotta just handle a couple loose ends here today, and I think we'll be all right. I want him fucking dead. I want this piece of shit fucking dead. This guy says he's a janitor. I'm gonna fucking put a hit on him. I know where he is.
And it's as easy as that. 1 minute, you're part of this thing of ours. You're putting food on the table for your family. Next, the boss wants you dead, and your head's on the chopping block, and there's nothing you can do.
I got him tracked. I know everywhere he is.
So how's the new house coming along?
Our new house is nice. It's very nice. You know, I'm having a little, you know, trouble furnishing it. The fucking goddamn furniture company won't call me back, so I'm having issues getting some things down, you know? I mean, do you know where Silver Lake City is? I mean, everybody knows. Yeah, Silver Lake City, and then you got, you know, Silver Lake South. There's a residential neighborhood to the west. All right, well, you gotta be quick, because I already know where the fuck he's meeting somebody. He's supposedly meeting somebody at McDonald's right now. West side of the main city. You know, I'll give you a nice hefty paycheck for this, alright? So yeah, he's literally on the west side of the main city right now, by the circle. He's wearing some sort of puffer jacket. It's like a beige-ish looking one. And I know he's driving he's got a fancy-ass black vehicle. I think it says Black H or something like that on the license plate. You'll see it. And tell him who it's from, alright? I need you to tell him, you wanted war, alright? Just say you wanted war, and then he's gonna be done.
What the fuck's that?
Fucking old man couldn't do it, man. He fucking just died.
How many people does Black have?
I don't know, I just saw four people there.
How did he know?
I don't know, he walked up, he was talking shit, and then he fucking got wrecked.
I'm just gonna make a call, I'll be right back.
Hello?
Mr. Black. Mr. Black.
Sir.
This is Anthony D'Angelo, how you doing?
I'm doing good, man, how are you, sir?
Not too bad. And I heard that, you're no longer part of this family. Now, he doesn't know I'm making this phone call, okay? So, I just want to say that... I just want to ask how you're doing, because, honestly... I've got my concerns with this leadership at the moment. And I want to know what you're getting yourself into.
But you're with Timothy?
I can see right him right now. He's just down the road.
Okay. So you just want to see what's going on with, leadership?
Right. Exactly. Because...
I can tell you this, man. Timothy already tried to whack me with one assassin.
How do you know it was him? How do you know it was him?
How did I know it was him? A fucking guy came up to me.
Yeah. Right.
Fucking black car, black suit. Okay. Fucking old man disguised in a fucking mafia car. Go out and he tried to smooth talk me, then pulled his gun and like get on the ground and I fucking managed to taste his balls and shoot him in the fucking back of his head.
All right, okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I understand.
I declared war on Timothy. That happens. I know 100% it's Timothy.
All right. Well, listen. A war is not going to benefit anybody. Okay? We're all here to make money, right?
Sir, with all due respect, a war will benefit me.
Why's that?
Why is that? Because I have around 35, 40 people behind my back. Timothy have around 10 people, but, and here's the good part. Timothy have maximum 4 or 5 people with him all the time. I can bring the whole city with me all the time.
That's fine, but when people are shooting and dying, they're not out there making money and putting food on our tables for our families.
Oh, I see what you mean, man, but I don't need to make money when I just could, rob the family. You see what I'm saying?
Right. Well, I'll tell you.
You guys make the money and I rob your ass. I know all the bank accounts, you know?
I'm sympathetic to your cause here. Maybe perhaps we can work together in the future. You let me know, okay?
Okay, man. I will tell you this, man, because I like you. You sound like a real gentleman. I will tell you this, man. You want to stay in the family on the good side, go on Randy's side. Because Timothy's side is going to die. The Randy side, I will not judge because I respect Mr. Randy. He's a fine gentleman, fine businessman. But the Timothy side will rot and wipe on one. And if you're on that side, I don't want something to happen to you. See what I'm saying?
Yeah. All right, well... it's good to talk to you. And,
you too, man.
I'll be with Timothy at the moment, but, Let's try and avoid any bloodshed for now, okay?
See you later.
Going outside the family for this hit was a bad move. Yeah, it splits apart you from the crime. But you get unreliable, absolutely fucking amateur people to carry it out. So T decided to put me in charge of it. I quickly hit the streets to find where this piece of shit Black was hiding.
I'll be very clear who I am. I work for Mr. Dirty Randy. That's why I'm speaking.
You know
to
what?
You, so
do me a fucking favor. And take your fucking mask off when you speak to me.
Right.
You're close to you're close to this Black prick.
I can call him up, and he let me track him and tag him earlier for his quote unquote safety.
And I tell you what, just knowing shit and following people around ain't gonna get you anywhere. You know what fucking gets you somewhere? Actions, my friend, doing fucking stuff to benefit the business, to benefit the fucking family. Can
sure.
you get Saeed Black alone?
You know what? Is he awake right now?
Yeah, I don't think he's awake right now, but can you get him alone?
Next time you're on, or awake with Mr. McApone, or just next time you're awake, and he's awake with you, I can get him alone. I got him alone earlier, I can do it again, no problem.
Alright, here's my fucking number.
Mm-hmm.
Take it. I tell you what. You get Saeed Black alone, you give me a fucking call, okay? With the Saeed Black situation under control and the wheels in motion, we could focus on other stuff. T, well, he made my fucking day when he made me a made man of his family.
I've been waiting for a nice special moment here. My man Tony right here. You're gonna be my first made man, alright?
That's an honor, T. It's an honor.
You know what? We've gone a long way back, you know, 10 years in the slammer. You've already put so much fucking time into it.
Killian!
Hey, what's up?
I tell you what I wanna hear, okay? And I know you can fucking do it because you're a legend like that, okay? I wanna hear fucking Volare, and don't tell me you can't do it.
You wanna hear Volare?
Volare.
Oh boy.
You know.
Oh boy.
Volare.
Oh boy. Oh,
come on.
I don't know, man. I mean, you're asking a lot of me here.
You know, come on.
You know.
Come
you know.
On.
I don't know this fucking. This song?
Hey, how much was that deal worth?
By Amy Winehouse?
Mark, no, Ron, no, not fucking Amy Winehouse. Fucking
what
Dino,
the fuck
man.
You talking about?
Dino.
Oh, Jesus Christ, what are you doing to me here?
Volare. Hey, I don't want to hear anyone fucking talking while we listen to the song here, okay?
I don't know the fucking song!
Oh, Jesus Christ, okay, sing something from fucking Dino, okay?
Christ!
Something from Dino. What about that? Ain't that a kick in the head?
Alright, I'll try it out.
Alright. There we go. Alright. You have to listen to this shit, T. Here we go.
How lucky can one guy be? I kissed
Fuck!
Her and she...
This was me at my peak. Nothing could stop me. I had T in my corner. I was a made man. I ran my own crew. I was making money upon money upon money. But the family started to grow. And as it grew, a few bad eggs trickled in. Look. Alright, let's go with the boys.
Look like shit.
You know, why don't you fuck yourself, who are you?
With
your suit and your fucking cap.
Yo,
show some
class,
will
you? The
hell
are you with your first day of school looking motherfucking haircut, you?
Hey, Johnny, he looks like one of those Jersey boys, doesn't he? One of those Jersey chooches.
He looks like someone squirted some mustard on a suit all over the place.
Fuckers. Don't know who you're fucking talking to.
A guy that got squirted with mustard? Is that who we're talking to?
No, not at all.
Did you get permission from your mom to get that haircut?
Hey, Twin, let's go. Let's go back to the fucking house.
Have a safe drive, boys.
Yeah, thank you.
Hello?
Fucking everyone's a tough guy nowadays. They just show up and they think they're the fucking big deal. Damn. See you later, fellas.
Call me, done.
Mustard suit, you ditched the suit, nice. You're riding with us, let's go.
No, I'm fucking not. Okay, fuck yourself.
Don't be a little pansy bitch boy. Get in the car.
That's what did you call me?
Called you a pansy bitch boy. You have a hard time hearing?
I'm a fucking made man, and he's secondhand man.
Look, just because you were made in the land of kangaroos doesn't mean shit here. You piece of shit. You know, this is what I have to think about your shit. You know what? Here.
Shut your fucking face.
Shoot this off, bitch.
Boys.
Oh.
Really?
Oh, I've been holding that for a couple hours. That's what I thought. You're not gonna do jack shit. Made man, my fucking cock.
All right, now I got mine out. How's that feel?
Yeah, good. Feels fucking. Huh? Mate, you want to fucking good, right? Die? Take a shot. Take a shot. You're fucking dead in this town.
Yeah, I'm sure about that, sweetheart. Say hello to Paulie for me, would ya?
I was conflicted. I knew I had every right to put a bullet in both their fucking heads. But to do so, I'd be doing it without T's approval. And that just isn't right. All I remember about that drive back home was that I was so angry, I blacked out.
Hello?
Killian.
Yeah? What's going on,
Tony? I need fucking help.
Where are you? Where do you need help?
fucking hurt. I've been in a car accident. If you go towards where the boss's house is, you'll see my fucking car wrecked on the side of the road. I'm on the grass next to it.
Yeah, alright, I'll be right there.
Alright.
Hey, Jersey boy, you have an accident? Don't got a repair kit? What happened?
Oh, that's too bad. Jersey boy didn't learn how to drive.
What happened? Need a repair kit?
Looks pretty beat up to me, Johnny. Look at him.
Are you sure you don't need a ride? You look pretty fucked up. Your face looks even more fucked up than it did before. You okay? He might not be breathing. I don't know. Does he look like he's breathing to you? Oh.
He's moving.
I think he shit his pants. Yo, Jersey boy, if you need a ride, get in the car. You're telling the truth. We're family.
He definitely shit himself.
You alright, Tony?
Hey, what's going on?
Move out. I'll fucking jump in here.
Got shit running down his leg. You see that, Johnny?
It's pride.
Oh, Jesus. Pride, that's hers. Jesus, guy, come on, guys. Jesus, come on. Do you want me to repair your car, or are you just going to roll with us?
No.
You all right?
Those two fucking guys are dead.
Hey, Tony, what's going on, man? We're meeting back at the house.
See? I'm at the hospital at the moment, getting some fucking treatment. When I get back, I need to have a meet with you.
All right, yeah, sure, man, no problem. Okay.
Very fucking important.
That's good. All right.
Follow me, T. This is very important,
right, you're
man.
You're sitting next to me. I like your tie, buddy.
Me? Thank you.
You all right, man? What the hell, man? You're looking a little different here.
Is that, like, your thing? Or...
Tony, just get to the house. Well, I'll talk to you in a second, all right?
No, I'm not coming to the house.
Come on.
You're not talking to me.
I can't work with people that have no respect for this thing. I'm sorry.
All right, hold on. I got a lot of people looking at me right now. We'll talk about it in like 2 minutes, okay?
Guy, why are you in the street?
They don't respect the family, they don't respect me. So, if that's the way the family, and that's the way the direction the family's going, I don't want that part of it. I'll find another way to make money. To be pissed on by some fucking prick wearing a fucking suit and a baseball cap. Fuck that. This is where I'm standing right now. The only reason why I'm not there right now is because if I was there right now, I'd put a fucking bullet in that Johnny's head. I'd put a bullet in that fucking Donnie's head. And then I'd fucking get whacked.
Yeah,
so out of respect to fucking T and his decisions, I'm not gonna fucking whack him. Because I still have respect for this thing. I don't whack anybody unless the boss says so. And I know that if I was there, I wouldn't be able to fucking contain myself. I'd have to fucking do it.
So you need to fucking show them what happens when you fucking do this shit.
Yeah.
Or do I have to fucking show them?
I'll tell you what I fucking do. You know what make me happy? Let's see. How about if I cut Johnny's head off with a fucking spoon, then I can shoot the kneecaps out of that fucking Donnie prick, cut off his balls and shove it down Johnny's throat, then I'd be very happy, I'd happily come back. I adore T. I'll do anything for that fucking guy, take a bullet for him, I'd fucking die for him. But I'm not gonna work alongside fucking clowns that would look better in clown makeup than a fucking suit. It's clear to me that he's made his decision who he wants to surround himself with. Okay? and I'm sorry. I can't be in the same room with these people. T put the fucking clothes on their back. Without T, they're fucking nothing. They've done nothing. They haven't done fucking shit. And they're walking around town as if they're fucking big shots. And they're the gangsters of the town. When you piss on a fucking maid, man. And in fact, when you piss on a fucking family member. Just in general. You've made your fucking bed.
Have you talked to Nino?
If T's the boss that I think he is. Then I won't have to kill Johnny and Donnie. If T's the boss that I think he is. He'll fucking whack him. He'll whack him. Without even me even fucking telling him. They should already be fucking dead. Because not only when they piss on me, they piss on him. Because he made me a fucking made man. He made that choice. He made me his fucking second. And they pissed on his fucking second. And he's going to let him fucking walk around. You fucking kidding me?
Well, you know what? I'm going to talk to him, all right?
Well, you talk to him.
All right.
Have a good one.
Hey guys, this is VERTiiGO, and thank you for watching. If you made it this far, it's a long fucking video, and I apologize. As you can hear, I'm really, really sick. Probably the sickest I've been in a long time. And it just seems to be one thing after the goddamn other. And as you could probably hear in the video, my voice was deteriorating the longer the video went, and trust me, this was a really, really tough edit. It's not a perfect video. I mean, I could have done a better job if I was feeling better, but I haven't, you know, uploaded in a couple of days, and I didn't want to keep holding it off. I really wanted to get a video out there for you guys, so that's why it's a bit longer, it's less trimmed down. I'm sorry there's a lack of action in it, but this is a very story-driven story. I guess you could say, because I have such respect for, you know, mafia and mob films that I really wanted to make sure that this story was really cool. And, you know, I still don't know where it's going to lead. I haven't recorded the rest of it yet. This was pretty much all the footage that I gathered up after the last few days. And as I said, I'm getting worse and worse, so I'm going to take tomorrow off. I'm not going to record tomorrow. Hopefully I feel better for Sunday's Conquest in Rust. I really hope I am. I really want to play that. So I'm going to try my best. Anyway, I'm rambling on, guys. Thank you. Thank you once again for watching the video, guys. Oh, and also, I just want to say sorry as well. There's a couple clips in the video that were really, really crappy quality. Unfortunately, my recording software stopped recording for no reason whatsoever. And it was such an important event that I had to, you know, go to my friend's stream and get the video from the stream. And it's not as good quality, but it had to be in the video, so I apologize for that as well. I love you all. Thank you for taking the time. This has been VERTiiGO, and until next time, may the Force be with you, always.